Welcome to WARN, today world news headlines are: Indian Navy in search for submarine display and information systems. The Indian Navy has been looking to equip its submarine fleet with new technologies to assist in navigation. The Navy has issued a request for information, RFI, to procure 11 submarine version warship electronic chart display and information system, WECDIS, along with its associated equipment. According to the RFI, the WECDIS is to be installed on board submarines of the Indian Navy, IN, and will be one of the means of navigation on board. The WECDIS should therefore offer features which assist in navigating a submarine when on surface and in dived state underwater, DefenseWorld.net reports. Army Chief Bipin Rawat calls for united efforts to tackle stone-pelting problem. Army Chief General Bipin Rawat today called for coordinated efforts by security forces to effectively deal with the problem of stone-pelting by civilians during counterinsurgency operations in Kashmir. The Army Chief discussed the issue with local Army officers during security review meetings at headquarters of counterinsurgency units, Kilo Force and Victor Force here, an Army official said. Reinforcing the need to maintain high vigil, the Army Chief discussed the issue of stone pelting during operations and impressed upon all to synergize efforts with the other security agencies in dealing with such situations effectively, the official said. Terma partner wins Indian warship radar contract. India's Nova Integrated Systems, in partnership with Terma AS, has signed an Indian Ministry of Defence contract to provide naval surface surveillance radar. The award, the value of which was not disclosed, involves the delivery, installation and commissioning of the radar systems on Indian Navy vessels. NISL's delivery of simulators, establishment of depot-level facilities and integrated logistics support for 10 years are also covered. Indian Navy pushes HAL for unmanned helicopters to keep an eye on China in a bid to accomplish requirement of unmanned platforms for Indian armed forces in fixed time frame. India's government-owned Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, HAL, has decided to abandon the Israel-helped project to convert two-ton class Cheetah into unmanned helicopter. Instead, HAL has invited global firms with proven capabilities in specific areas of design and development for conversion of two-ton class helicopters into rotary unmanned aerial vehicle, RUAV. With Su-30 firing BrahMos, India can conduct precision surgical strikes 300 kilometers away, while the first carriage flight of Sukhoi-30 MKI fighter aircraft with BrahMos missile only a dummy drop was successfully achieved in June 2016. The firing of the actual supersonic missile is now scheduled for April. This integration will allow India to order surgical strikes destroying targets about 300 kilometers away. With 70 kilometers range, Israel's missiles worth $2.50 billion to seal our borders AR 17,000 crore, $2.50 billion, deal has been cleared by the government for jointly developing with Israel a medium-range surface-to-air missile, Mr. SAM, for the Army, reflecting India's fast-growing defense ties with the Jewish nation. The project will be implemented by the DRDO, Defense Research and Development Organization, and an Israeli aircraft industry, IAI. India building a supercomputer juggernaut. Come June, India will likely unveil its most powerful supercomputer. If its processors operate at the full capacity of 10 petaflops, one followed by 15 zeros of floating point operations per second, a clock speed a million times faster than the fastest consumer laptops, it could earn a place among the world's top 10 fastest supercomputers. IAF to float tenders for midair refuelers again after two failed attempts. India is set to launch a fresh hunt for midair refuelers to expand strategic reach of its air force after two failed attempts to induct new tankers. The Indian Air Force will soon float a tender for at least six midair refuelers that could cost upwards of $2 billion, an air marshal familiar with the development said. Russian Project 667 BDR Delta III Class SSBN Ryazan returned to permanent base after upgrade. The Project 667 BDR Delta III Class, nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine, SSBN, Ryazan has returned to its home station in Kamchatka in Russia's Far East after it was upgraded and repaired, Russian Eastern Military District spokesman for the Pacific Fleet Captain 2nd Rank Vladimir Matveyev said. Leonardo heralds French UAV radar selection. Officials at Italy's Leonardo are celebrating after the company's small E-scan radar Picosar cracked one of the toughest defense markets in the world, neighboring France. Leonardo officially announced on Monday that the Picosar radar would fly on the patroller UAV acquired last year by the French Army, with first deliveries this year. The patroller, produced by French firm Sagem, beat off competition from the Thales Watchkeeper UAV to win the contract, helped by its higher percentage of French content. US departs Aero India, leaves stronger relationships behind US aircraft, crew and support personnel, as well as members of the Department of State and other US representatives returned home this week after a strong showing at Aero India 2017 at Air Force Station Yelahanka, India, February 20. On the heels of the recently announced major defense partnership between the United States and India, the representation of American air power and the robust senior-level U.S. government delegation present during the show demonstrated the U.S. commitment to India, a growing and pivotal relationship. F-35 to fight ISIS in a few years. The F-35A's Middle East deployment is not imminent and is planned a few years out, U.S. Air Force Air Combat Command Chief Gen Herbert Carlisle told reporters February 24. It's unclear now whether the jet will have increased software capabilities by that point or will remain in the current Block 3I configuration. When the F-35A reached initial operational capability this summer, it fell short of its planned Block 3F configuration, which would have increased the aircraft's weapons capacity and improve its targeting capability. The U.S. Air Force expects Blocks 3F and 4 will be available by 2018 and 2021. Thanks for watching. Please like and share. Please comment your opinion for this news. Press subscribe button for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, WARN.